Good afternoon, engineers, all of you. Today I am here to continue further the exercise 7.1 where I have stopped. In the previous video, I have told you that how to identify a cube number. I have told you when you need to identify a cube number, you have to apply the method of prime factorization. That when you apply the prime factorization, and whatever the prime factors you have got for that particular number, if they could be arranged in a pair of 3, then we can conclude that given number is a perfect cube number. Otherwise they won't set it as perfect cube number. And second thing, I have told you how to find it out what could be the ones digit of a cube of a given number. That when you need to find it out the ones digit of a cube of any number, then you have to make the cube of the unit digit. Whatever the unit digit you will get after making the cube, that could be the ones digit of a cube number. Continuing further, now here for the second, third and fourth question we are going to do today. In second question, first, third and fifth part is the homework, and in third question, first, second and fourth part is homework. In the second question, we need to find it out what could be the least number by which could be multiplied to make it a perfect cube. And in the third, we need to find it out what could be the least number by which it could be divided to make it a perfect cube number. I hope least number to be multiplied or least number to be divided. Related to this, you have already solved question in the previous exercise, that is square and square root. We are going to apply the same concept. We'll apply the first prime factorization for the given number. We'll try to make a pair of 3. If a pair of 3 for some number, if it is not possible, we'll try to provide to that number to find it out what is the least number to be multiplied. And when for finding least number to be divided, if any extra number is there after making the pair of 3, then we'll remove that number from the given number. So that will give you the least number to be divided. I'm showing you example, like for the second part, the number is given as 256. Here we need to find it out what's the least number to be multiplied. So as I've told you, when you need to find it out least number to be multiplied, so first of all we'll again apply the prime factorization method. So with 2 that become 128, with 2 that 64, then again 32, 16, 8, 4, 2, 1. Now when you form a pair of 3, you are seeing that one pair of 2 is missing. After making two correct pair of 3, one pair of 2 is missing. So you will conclude it as 2 is the least number by which it should be multiplied. Now, although here it is not asked, now suppose before it asked, I'll let you know what's the sign of cube root. As you are already aware that this is the sign of square root. Similarly, in this sign only, if you write 3 here, that becomes the sign of cube root. It means if a normal root is made in this way, that will be called as square root. If any 3 is there, 4, 5, 6 and so on is there. If 3 is there, that's called 3 cube root. 4 is there, that's called 4th root. 5 is there, that's called 5th root. 6 is there, that's called 6th root and so on. So till for 2 and 3, that's the if nothing is there, it means 2 is there. So if nothing could be said for this given number, that nothing is written here, so that is called as square root. If 3 is written here, that is called cube root. Although here it is not asked what after finding the least number to be multiplied, what could be the cube root, then also I am showing you as the 2 is the smallest number by which we are multiplying. So here multiply 2 here, and here the 2 which was lacking, that will provide here also, that all the number will be in the pair of 3. So 256 into 2, that becomes 512, and that's the cube of 8. So cube root of 512, that becomes 8. And if you remember, in the last class when I've given you the cube number, the value of 8 cube was also coming as 512. So this way you are going to find it out the least number to be multiplied to make it a perfect cube. First of all, form the pair of 3. If any number remains which is not forming in the pair of 3, that will be the least number to be multiplied. With that number, multiply on both the sides so that on the right side become cube form and the left side become the perfect cube. And when you remove the cube from here, that gives the cube root here, and this way you will get your answer. So this is the second part, where 2 was the least number to be multiplied to make it a perfect cube. Now if I go for the fourth part of it, where the number is 675. So if I go for the fourth part, where the number is 675, we'll apply the same process. First of all, we'll find it out all the prime factors of it. With 2 is not possible. We'll start it with 3. So 3 2s and 2 25, again 3 75, again 3 25, 5 5s, 5 1s. Here only we are forming the pair of 3. Pair of cube of 5 is not forming, it means 1 5 is missing. So the 5 is the least number by which it should be multiplied. So when you multiply 675 by 5 now, and here also 1 5 is given, so now it will form equal pair of 3. So now this become 5 5s are 25, 5 7s are 35, 37, 5 6s are 30, 3 7 5 and 15 cube. Then cube root of double 3 7 5 become 15. So this way you will be find it out the least number to be multiplied to make it a perfect cube. So this is for the least number to be multiplied. Now when it asks for least number to be divided, again we are going to apply the same process. Only that instead of writing multiply, we'll write divided. So let's see for the third question, third part. Third question, third part is for 135. So if you see for 135, find it out the prime factors of 135. So with 3, that become 45, with 3, 15, with 3, 5, 5. Only one pair of 3 is forming, 5 is not in pair. So 5 is the least number by which it should be divided. Now instead of multiply, now we'll write divided. So instead of multiplying, now we'll divide it by 5, and from here, so that 5 which was came here, that came in the form of divide. So there is no 5 remains. So now this become 27 equals to 3 cube, and hence cube root of 27 becomes 3. I hope this is quite easy. So when you need to for multiply, you will multiply with the missing values. And when it is asked for divide, you will remove that extra value, that will give you the answer. I hope this is clear. Now let's go for the fifth part. As fifth part is for 704. Again here we apply the same thing. 704. Let's find it out prime factors. So we'll start with 2, 3, 5, 2, again 2. 176, again 2, 88, again 2, 44, again 2, 22, again 2, 11, and then finally 11, 1s are 11. Now when you make a pair of 2, we are seeing that 11 is not coming in pair. So here the least number to be divided become 11. So 11 is the least number by which it should be divided. So now we'll divide 704 by 11. And we'll remove 11 from here, so that will be 64, and that is 4 cube. So now cube root of 64 become 4. So this is your third question. In the rest of the part also you need to do the same thing. When it is asked to least number to be multiplied, again form the pair and check which number are not in pair. If suppose here only, if it is asked least number to be multiplied, I would have multiplied by 211. It means 11 into 11, I would have multiplied by 121. Now when it is asked the least number to be divided, as this number is not coming in pair, I will divide my given number by the number which is not in pair to make it in the form of perfect cube. As you were already doing in the previous chapter, that is square and square root, where it was asking the least number to be multiplied, the least number to be divided. There also the number which was not coming in pair, we used to multiply with that, or the number which was not coming in pair, we used to divide with that. Same concept we are going to apply here also. When we make the pair of 3, there whatever the remaining where numbers will be there, with the pair of the same will multiply or will divide with the same with the given number to make it in the form of perfect cube. So this is about question number 3. Now coming to question number 4, which says that Parikshit makes a cuboid of plasticine 5 cm, 2 cm and 5 cm. How many such cuboid will be used to form a cube? If you find it out the volume of that cuboid, volume of cuboid, that is 5 into 5 into 2. So that become 50 cm cube. Now as you know that in cube all side must be same. So by here only you can see, decide that how many pair we are getting. As here we are getting two values of 5 and one values of 2. If you make it in the form of perfect cube, I require one value of 5 and two values of 2 to make it in the form of perfect cube. So when you need to find it for perfect cube, so volume of that cube, volume of desired cube should be, there should be equal values, equal length, equal breadth and equal height. So along with this, I need one more values of 5, and along with one values of 2, I require two more values of 2, that is 2 into 2 into 2. As two values of 5 and one values of 2 is already given there. 5 into 2 is already given there, that's the value of cuboid. Now when you need to convert it in the form of cube, all side must be same. It means if I give him one values of 5 and two values of 2, then you will see that there are three values of 5 and three values of 2. It means now it should form a cube. So let's get the volume of desired cube. It means what the volume of that expected cube will be, that only we are finding. So 5 5s are 20, 5 2s are 50, 5 2s are 10, 2s are 100. Five fives are 25, 2s are 50, 2s are 100 into 10, 1000. So 1000 centimeter cube is the expected volume of the desired cube. So how many cube needed for the same? So number of cube, how many cuboid needed? Number of cuboids needed, that will be 1000 divided by 50. That become 20 cuboids. So we require 20 more cuboids so that our previous cuboid will convert in the form of cube. I am explaining it again. It says that Parikshit makes a cuboid of dimension was 5 into 5 into 2. So first of all, we have calculated the volume of that cuboid. The volume of that cuboid came out as 50 centimeter cube. Now that cuboid has to be converted in the form of cube. So as you know that in cube all sides must be equal. It means whatever the length and breadth or height, that should all be equal. So now here we are getting two different values. So here to make it in the form of cube, there should be equal pair of 3. So what should be the volume of desired cube? It means whatever cube we are making after adding cuboid to that number, what will be the volume of that number? So first we have calculated that. If we are already having two pair of 5 and one values of 2, I'll give one values of 2 and one pair of 2. So that this 5 will again become equal and 2, 2, 2 all become in pair of 3. So 5 will also become in pair of 3 and 2 will also become a pair of 3. So it means now it will form a cube. So volume of that desired cube was coming out as 1000 centimeter cube. Now the number of cuboid needed. So what will the cuboid, how many cuboid will add to that previous cube or previous cuboid to make it in a form of cube? That was the desired cuboid volume will divided by the previous. We got 20 cuboid. It means if we add 20 cuboids to previous cuboid, our previous cuboid will be converted in the cube whose side will be 10 and whose volume will be 1000. So this is your fourth question. I hope this is clear. For any query, you must ask your subject teacher. I hope this is clear. This is all about today's class. In the next class, we'll try to discuss the prime factorization method for finding the cube root. Till then, stay safe, stay happy. Thank you and Jai Hind.